In the name of Allah, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Dear audience, this is Language and Linguistics Online. I am Dr. Khurram Shahzad from National University of Modern Languages, Islamabad. Today, I intend to talk about language standardization process. So in this video, I will be talking about how usually one dialect of the language, it is converted into a standard dialect of the language. We should remember that it is a political decision which is made by the government. And of course, they take into consideration different social factors. They take into consideration that what kind of language educational institutions they are making use of, and what kind of language professors or lawmakers they are making use of, to what kind of dialect they are giving priority. So in this way, usually a political decision is made. And once that political decision is made, the rest of the dialects, they are marginalized. This is the end result of standardization. So somehow or the other, usually one dialect is converted into a standard dialect of the language. So language standardization refers to the process by which a language is codified, tadween ki jati hai, codified and established with uniform grammatical, orthographical and phonological rules to be used by a specific community. So of course, it is a political decision, as when Pakistan came into being, Qaid-e-Azam Muhammad Ali Jinnah made a political decision. So he decided that Urdu will be the national language and English will be the official language of Pakistan. Standardization serves as a means of fostering communication. So of course, in this way, we foster communication among different segments of the society, identity and social unity. And in this way, identity is socially constructed and unity among the people, it is strengthened, as well as enabling practical functions such as governance, education and literature. So once the political decision is made that this dialect will be used as the official dialect or the standard dialect, so the very first thing is that we will have to construct books. We will have to write books. We will have to generate grammatical books, and dictionaries will have to be codified. And of course, government departments will be making use of that standard dialect. In educational institutions, that standard dialect will be made use of, and literature will be produced in that dialect. Language standardization often evolves alongside nation building and modernization. Examples include the standardization of English, like Shakespearean period, and German language, for example. And in order to do all these things, establishment of dictionaries and grammar books, it is very important. And in this way, certain language departments, the government is supposed to open. There are 5 stages of language standardization. Number 1 is selection. So of course, when the selection is made out of so many other dialects, so this is a political decision which is made by the government in consultation with the professors, teachers, lawmakers, or those who are writing with the specific dialect literature that they are producing. So choosing a dialect to be standard, often a prestigious variety like King's English, is selected for standardization process. Number 2 is codification, formalizing grammar rules, what is to be included, what is to be excluded, neologisms to be excluded, slang words to be excluded from the standard variety. All these decisions are made by the government, because government always establishes different groups, and you know, these groups, they comprise professors of the university, and then they decide what is to be the part of the standard variety of language and what is to be excluded from that standard variety. So spellings, they are determined. Pronunciation rules, they are determined. This stage involves the production of dictionaries, grammar books and other reference material. So once all these things are carried out, it means that the codification is completed. And once the codification is completed, The third stage is elaboration. Elaboration means the explanation of these rules in different books. The explanation of syntactic structures in different books. The explanation of phonological and morphological rules in different books. So once again, the authors, they pick up the pen and they start codifying, start elaborating different kinds of books. So this is a long process. It may take 1 to 2 years to complete. Expanding the standard variety's ability to function in diverse areas such as science, politics, and culture. So of course, whenever any scientific journal or article is to be produced, the students, the learners, the professors, they will be making use of the standard dialect of language. Whenever people, they are delivering speeches, political leaders, they are delivering political speeches, they will be making use of standard dialect of that language. So on television, people will be speaking that dialect. So once that political decision is made, and in this way, language, it goes through the process of standardization. Number 4 is implementation. And of course, for the implementation, government has made up different kinds of departments like colleges, universities, schools, where books are taught and these books are written in the standard dialect of that language. The process of encouraging or enforcing the use of standard language in education, media and government. So in this way, the standard dialect, it will be implemented. Once the books are produced, students will be reading those books. Once the dramas or movies are made, they will be telecast in that variety of language. And in this way, people, they will come across that variety and consciously or unconsciously, they will acquire or learn that variety of language. And last point is acceptance. The social process where the population begins to accept and use the standard variety in formal context, and the process of standardization is complete. Selection, codification, elaboration, implementation, and acceptance. There are certain factors that we should keep in our mind once this process of standardization, it is going on. Political factors. So governments may impose a standard language to unify a country or suppress minority languages. Since there are so many languages that we are speaking in Pakistan, Punjabi, Pashto, Seraiki, Balochi, but Urdu is our national language and it is a source of social integration and unity among people. And English is the official language of Pakistan. So educational policies, they are produced in that variety. Schools play a key role by teaching the standard language as the norm. Media, the widespread use of standard language in print and broadcast media helps its dissemination, spread. And technological changes. The rise of digital communication has led to the rapid standardization of new language forms such as textbooks English in online communities. So no doubt globalization, it has also played a constructive role. So these days, even in the villages of Pakistan, people, they are not making use of their dialect. They are quite often making use of the standard variety of language or Urdu language. And in this way, social integration is going on. Unity among the people, it is further strengthening. So in this video, I have talked about the process of standardization. There are 5 stages that I have talked about. First of all, political decision is made and selection of the dialect is made. Then there is codification, then elaboration, then implementation and acceptance. Thank you very much.